Our next speaker has been writing and illustrating his own books for the last couple of years. Before that, he worked as an artist, exhibiting and selling paintings since the 1960s. Before that, he has been working as a technician for KLM for a decade or two or so. He is now 7 years away from his first centennial. Please welcome Max Farion.
Hello everybody. My name is Max Farion. I wrote a book about human intelligence. Most animals also have intelligence, but much less than humans. For example, to transfer a message, a lion urinates a bush. We put a letter in a mailbox. A lot of research has been done to find out how our brains operate when thinking intelligently. Still, there is not even a general agreement of what intelligence is. It is a hinder if you don't know what to look for. Usually, scientific research is applied to find an answer to a question about a phenomenon. I approach the question in a different way. People sometimes use their imagination to solve a problem and see how it works. I did the same and replaced research with imagination. My imagination says intelligence is the power of the brain to create a new manipulation which is advantageous to the manipulator. Manipulation is here processing objects and matter and not misleading someone. An example is you see our predecessor in prehistoric times eating fruits. At the left, he is still biting the fruits from the branches, but he developed hands which enabled him to pick the fruits. His intelligence created a better manipulation because he could reach fruits too far away from his mouth. Manipulation is the core of my theory. Why manipulation and not speech or social behavior? Manipulation brought us a highly developed society. The chimp on the left could already crush a nut with a rock. Man made the wheel and at that part his bolts and nuts. Speed and behavior were essential but did not actually create our prosperity. How did an animal become intelligent? A child does not always inherit exactly the same genes as his parents. Sometimes a gene deviates from copying. We call this a mutation. A gene defines a property. When a new property means better survival, it will remain as a new property. In this way, also intelligence originated. See intelligence as a bottle containing manipulations. Manipulations were added as a result of intelligence. But the bottle has a limited content. No more new manipulations could be added to a full bottle. This is a part of my theory. When the bottle was full, a new mutation could enlarge the bottle. Now the creation of new manipulations could be continued until either the manipulation power was exhausted or the bottle was full again. Now another look. The mutation with generated intelligence occurred to all animals since the time they existed. All animals have the power to create new manipulations. Whether it is a fish, bird or snake, it does not matter. But see how it works out. You see the lifelines of a fish, bird and chimpanzee. Each species of animals has its own history in evolving from protocell to the present state. During that evaluation, his bottle crew penning his capacity to manipulate. I will show you a few examples. A deer can scrape snow to reach grass, lick off a newborn calf, tear grass to eat, but not much more. He does not have the attributes to create any more new manipulations. His bottle stayed very small. A robin, the bird with the red breast, performs better. He can build an unbelievable ingenious nest from branches and straws, requiring many different manipulations with his bill only. A human hand can hardly imitate this, but a robin does it, but not much more. A jackdaw, the small nephew of the crow, is better still. He has a strong bill and claws, which can crash, he opens nuts. He can hoist a fat ball suspended at a rope. He is famous for his cleverness. But the champion among the animals is the chimpanzee. He uses rocks, sticks and straws as a tool, because his hands enabled him to do so. He crushes a nut with a rock and fishes ants out of their nest with a straw. But the champ, but the best mental manipulator in the world is us, because our hands are able to perform an almost unlimited variation in manipulations. We can split wood requiring much force, but also stick a thread through the eye of a needle requiring delicate maneuvering. Now we put the bottles together. The more an animal can manipulate, the more his bottle could evolve to a higher size. That is why animals differ in intelligence and why mankind exceeds all animals in intelligence. This Greek philosopher, who lived long before Christ, already saw a similarity between body shape and intelligence. A few authors of this time also assumed the hands to shape our brain. Today you are a witness of the birth of a new theory. A theory that explains exactly what intelligence is and how the hands were the facilitator to our intelligence. The major part of our intelligence was built up according to this theory during a period of 60 million years. Over the last 1 million years, our capacities expanded our intelligence. Still it is true, without hands, no intelligence. That is the title of my book. The basics of my theory can be written in 18 words. It takes a book to verify this theory. I hope to get this book to be published. Reactions are welcome. Copies are available on request. Thank you very much for your attention.